The One True Next podcast helps you build a TBR of future favorite books. In each episode, Lori Amin interviews authors and book influencers to recommend books they loved for you to pick up today. If you're an avid reader, always looking for your next great read, then this show's for you. So, hi, Katie. Welcome to One True Next podcast.
Hello. Thank you so much for having me, Laura.
So happy to have you here. So tell us a little bit about yourself.
Okay. Well, my name is Katie Cotugno. I always say I write messy, complicated feminist love stories. Birds of California is my adult debut, but I am the author of 7 YA novels, including the upcoming mystery Liar's Beach, which is based on Agatha Christie's first published novel, which is called The Mysterious Affair at Stiles. I'm also the co-author, along with Candace Bushnell, of Rules for Being a Girl. I'm based in Boston, where I live with my family and an extremely neurotic rescue dog who is barking in the background.
It is all good. I love when puppies make it a cameo. So I have to tell you, I was so glad. I read 99 Days and then the follow-up, and I was like so glad there was a follow-up for that book. I was like, I needed a follow-up. So thank you for giving me, you guys are my dream, giving me the sequel that I needed.
That was such a fun one to write. I was so excited that I got to do it.
Yeah. So let's chat about Birds of California. Tell us a little bit of pitch.
Yeah. Birds of California. Like I said, it's my adult debut. It is about a woman who everyone has written off and a guy that nobody takes seriously. Former child actress Fiona St. James dropped out of the spotlight 10 years ago after a spectacularly public crash and burn. She has put her humiliating past behind her, and she's not about to let anybody mess it up. Meanwhile, Sam Fox, who played Fiona's older brother on the popular television show Birds of California, loves all the perks that come with being a successful actor. But when his current show gets canceled and his agent starts to avoid his calls, Sam is desperate. And so he enthusiastically signs on to this reboot of Birds of California. But to make it happen, he needs Fiona St. James. And she is definitely not about to make it easy. So before you know it, they are discovering this deep sort of intense connection and falling in a kind of love that neither one of them have ever experienced before. But Sam doesn't know the truth behind Fiona's breakdown. And she is going to do everything possible to keep it that way.
And it is so good. It's like such a page-turner. So I have a question. Oh my gosh. I envisioned this to be like a Lindsay Lohan, Miley Cyrus, you know, kids TV show, like CW TV show.
Yes.
Yeah, you know, like kind of like soapy drama that we were tuning in, you know, years ago. And then we're like, and now in this like renaissance of TV, we're like reboots. This is what we need, you know?
Absolutely. Yes, 100%. I saw Lindsay Lohan in the Super Bowl commercial over the weekend. And like my heart exploded. I was like, Lindsay, it's you.
I know. I have a hope that she will become a housewives in Dubai since we now got to Dubai. And I'm like, I have hopes that she can just become one of the housewives, you know, like this could be her renaissance. But yeah, like it's like, it's like Fiona made it her job to break down, like to be like, make it like, I don't want to be seen. I don't want to deal with any of this stuff. I'm like hiding behind a coffee shop. Like when we meet her, we're like, what is she doing there?
Yes, she is working at her, she's gone from, being this famous television star to working at her parents' print shop. So she's printing banners, she's printing wedding invitations, and people, like the customers who come in are constantly like, hey, aren't you? And she like comes up with a sort of variety of responses to those folks.
So what was her, like, what do you like to write this book? Like, what was the source of inspiration for you? Like,
So I actually started this book. I originally conceived it as a YA project. Like probably 3 or 4 years ago. I was writing something else that wasn't working. And you know, like that's the thing about like great ideas for books is that like you always come up with them when you are working at something else that you're tired of. But I was just coming off writing Fireworks, which is, my boy band girl group 90s Florida book. And so my editor like wasn't thrilled necessarily about the idea of like doing another fame book so close together. So I just kind of put it in my back pocket and didn't think about it that much. And then at the start of the pandemic, I like actually was not one of those people who suddenly had a lot of time during the pandemic. We had a baby, and my mom, who has some health stuff, was staying with us. But it was the first time like I had nowhere to be. And so I just sort of sat down and kind of reconceived it as an adult project, something that was a little more grown up, a little sexier. I mean, I've been writing YA for a long time, but I'm getting older, honestly. And there are, like, I was really feeling like there were, you know, different kinds of stories that I wanted to tell, different kind of life issues that I was bumping up against that you know, I wanted to try and understand through fiction. And so it really was this project that like I was, it was like the one thing in, you know, the spring and summer of 2020 that I was like just doing for me. Like I was sneaking away and writing it in like these like really intense, like 15 minute bursts, like whenever, you know, the baby was sleeping or nobody needed me. And yeah, it was like, it was such a pleasurable, like nobody was waiting for it, obviously. Like I had never published an adult book before. I hadn't written anything that hadn't already been sold in almost 10 years. So it was just like such a special writing experience.
I love that it was a special writing experience because it was special to read it as an, you know, someone who has read your YA novels and be like, okay, what is her adult tone? Like, you know, and it was just like such a, like an experience of like just being transported to Hollywood, being transported to this world that I can conceive as a viewer, as an, you know, as a reader, as a viewer, like this is like a world that I'll consume, mm-hmm. you know, and being part of it and being part of the know. And so mm-hmm. I can imagine it's like a fun escape to be like in Hollywood, you know, like LA, like, you know, the sunny weather, like the beach trips, the stuff, yeah. like, you know, like that it's not just like staying at home indoors, you know.
Yes, absolutely.
So what are you working next? You mentioned some YA. So talk to us about the YA that are coming up. And then what are you?
So my next YA comes out in May of 2023. It's called Liar's Beach. And it's a riff on Agatha Christie's first published novel, The Mysterious Affair at Styles. And it's about a group of wildly wealthy and wildly secretive and wildly nefarious group of friends who are spending the summer on Martha's Vineyard together. And spoiler alert, someone turns up dead in the pool. And it kind of goes from there. The gimmick of Liar's Beach and the follow-up, which will be out in 2024, is, so Agatha Christie's most famous detective is Hercule Poirot. Mm-hmm. And in Liar's Beach, I've sort of reimagined him as a teenage girl named Holiday Proctor. Who is sort of a full click to cover for her own good. And she's been really, really fun to write.
Oh, this sounds so good. You have
it's gonna be, I think it's gonna be fun.
You have me at wealthy kids for behaving, they're probably behaving badly. So there's something to be said about that. So yeah. I love this. Oh, so good. So let's chat some book recommendations. Do you have any books you recommend our readers to pick up?
Let's see. The last thing I read that I really loved was Lauren Groff. Actually, I tend to read more on the like quote unquote literary side, which isn't to say that like obviously I don't think that YA and romance like have literary merit. Obviously, I do. Those are the books that I write. I love those kinds of books. But just like in terms of what I tend to pick up off the shelf, I tend to read a little more on the like the serious side, I guess. I just read Lauren Groff's Matrix, which is about a cloistered nun living in an English abbey in, I believe, the 1100s. It's like this deeply feminist and also like hugely cozy book. It's got these like detailed descriptions of the routines of the work in the abbey and the farming and the animals. And it's also just like a beautiful exploration of female relationships and the different ways that people wield power. And it's also just like gorgeously, gorgeously written. I love Lauren Groff. I think that she's brilliant. I also saw her, I went to one of her events once and this like very like sort of self-satisfied older man asked her if she was surprised by her own success. And she looked at him for a minute and she said, well, I work really hard and I'm really talented. So no.
Yes, this is how it's told. Yes,
right. I was like, I love you. It was amazing.
Yes. Oh my gosh. I love this. Oh, so awesome. So yes. Tell us where you can find you online.
Yes. So you can find me at katiecotugno.com is my website. And then I am Katie Cotugno across all the platforms. So that's where I am on Twitter, on Instagram. I have a Tumblr that I use to reblog pictures of attractive people making out and dogs wearing glasses. that's where to find me.
I love this. Katie, thank you, Katie, for being on the show.
Oh my gosh, Laura, thank you so much for having me. This has been amazing.
If you enjoyed this podcast, feel free to share with friends, subscribe, rate, and review the show. This is the easiest way to support the podcast. Today's episode's partner is Libra FM. If you're an audiobook listener, then you should add Libra FM as your go-to source for paid audiobooks. Libra FM makes it possible for you to buy audiobooks through your local bookstore. Memberships start at $14.95, and they also have great sales for romance audiobooks each month for $3.99, thanks to the Kiss Club. To sign up for Libra FM, please visit whattoreadnextblog.com/LibraFM. You will receive a free audiobook when you sign up for a monthly subscription. If you purchase a subscription through our link, you will be supporting the podcast at no cost to you. The What to Read Next podcast is part of the Frolic Podcast Network. Please visit frolic.media/podcast to discover new shows to tune in. Thank you so much for listening and have a great day.